What the fuck?
Hi folks, and welcome to my channel. Today we're going to talk about these goggles. These are DJI FPV goggles. I have V2 version, but this is not much different from the V1 version. The DJI as a company is a great company. It invents and brings to the market a lot of stuff that no one else can do. In this case, we have amazing goggles with HD picture and it works flawlessly, it works far. But one thing which is very important is missing. For me, the customization is the main word nowadays. You can customize almost everything around us, but the DJI products are very close. There are some functions, of course, that you can use and you can change a little bit, just a little bit, what DJI allows you. Actually, these goggles all run Linux OS, so it means they have a lot of potential to be used, but it was everything locked until now. Now the guys, this actually the same guys who brought us the DJI live video output from the goggles straight to your phone, straight to your Android. You can plug your phone to the goggles and see the picture. The same command made another great improvement to these goggles. They opened the root and opened Adb interfaces for these goggles. So it means that you can make now almost everything. These goggles are really powerful and they are powerful enough to play old games. Let me show you how to do it. Right before we start with the goggles itself, let's check what do we have to do. It's not as user-friendly as you could expect, but as I understood, the developers plan to make it better. For now, it's kind of a lot of text, but still not enough to understand everything, and also the unexperienced users will have some difficulties. But it's not a problem for now, let's try to do it step by step. First of all, we have to install Node.js. So we have to Google it. First link, download. I did it already. Take your time because the installation of Node.js takes some time. By me, it took around 25-30 minutes. It takes some time and it depends on your internet connection. After that, to install the JavaScript dependency, you have to download the repository. For that code, I already downloaded it and unzipped it here, DJI hack. Here is the folder. Next thing, you have to open the command line inside of this folder to install the dependencies. For this, let's open the command line. Let's type, I think we have to write down the letter of the drive, okay. And I will copy the folder from here, cd and the stuff. So we're inside of this folder, and now we can copy this command and try to execute it here. Very good, works. It says that there is another patch that can be updated. Let's try to update it. I don't know. Okay, added two packages. I assume it's updated now. After that, I will take my goggles. The SD card has to be not inside. So there is no SD card right now inside of the goggles. Now I turn on the goggles, okay, and plug in the USB cable. Before we exploit the security of the goggles, let's check the last step of it, DJI Assistant. You have to be sure that you're not on the particular firmwares. It says somewhere here that you are not allowed to be on the firmware 0015. At the same time, the firmware 0020 works. Let's check goggles. So 606 right now. It's fine. I'm allowed to install the hack. So after that, we come back to the command line. I didn't close it. Let's copy this command. Let's hope. Hang in there, it's going to take a few minutes. Found GP150. As you see, we came across the first error. It's the result E0. As we see, the developers already wrote some information about it, so you have to check what is happening. First of all, let's reboot the goggles. I turn it off and turn it on. Okay, the goggles restarted. Let's try it again. Hang in there, yeah. They say that the COM port in the Windows can change during the update reboot process. So it means due to the changed number of the COM port, it cannot work anymore. So you have to start it from the beginning and then it should work. Also, it's very important that you have to use only one device at a time. It means that you don't have to turn on your Air unit or Vista on your drone. It means that we turn on the goggles only, upgrade it, and after we finish, we can try it with the Vista or with the Air unit. Looks like it works now. During the previous attempt, it didn't work. I waited 25 minutes and it still didn't finish it. So the problem was, I don't know what exactly it is, but it actually makes difference if you plug in the USB cable before or after applying the power. The first try I did, leaving the USB cable plugged in, so that was a problem. After that, I unplugged it, restarted the goggles, and then plugged in the cable, and now it works. Yeah, look, device should be unlocked, try ADB devices. I am not sure, can I make it here? ADB devices. I didn't install ADB, but okay. Yes, yes, very, very good. I don't see really any difference right now. Device info is exactly the same as it was before. Currently, we unlocked the interface with the goggles. We can communicate it right now. But if you want to upgrade the firmware, update to the newest firmware for whatever reason you want, you have to lock it. So here is the command. Copy it here, paste in the command line, and press enter. That's it. Then the interface will be locked and you can use the DJI FPV assistant just normally to upgrade the firmware. Right now there are not too many use cases for this because the project is very fresh, very new. It was officially published 1 or 2 days ago, depends on when you're watching this video. So it means that the development progress is still going on. But at least for now, we can try to play the Doom. First of all, you have to download the file from the release. This is here, like 117 megabyte. Also, you have to download Doom WAD. This is archive. After some research in Google, I found this website. This is pcfreak.net, where I downloaded Doom 1 WAD file. There is also Doom 2, Doom 3, you can try whatever you want. First of all, we have to connect the goggles again. So I turn on the goggles and then plug in the USB cable. Looks like we are connected. ADB devices. Aha, device is here, it's fine. You have to run it in the folder that you created. Let's open the H drive and open this folder. Now we can run the command. File pushed, it means that it copied to the goggles. Not bad. I would rename the file if it named somehow differently to exactly like it's in the command. Yes. Okay, it's copied to the goggles. And now the last command. Okay. Looks like it works as it should. Now we have to check if which version of the goggles we have and to disable the graphical interface of the goggles. I have the goggles V2, so I use this LAN. I copy it, paste, it works. Now we have to start the ADB shell. ADB shell. We have to open the folder where we copied these files. It's the black box folder. Not block box, but black box. And now we have to start the file that we copied there. So the file was named like, what was the name? Doom. Okay, I think the problem is that the WAD file we uploaded is somehow not correct. Let's try to find something else. Something else not found. Oh my god, what is this? ST bar not found. What is this? I think is in this case we have to carefully pick the proper WAD file. So give me some time and I will show you the result. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Oh, it worked! It worked! Okay, it works. The footage, how it works, you will see here on the screen. But nevertheless, it's cool. It's very cool.
It's a huge improvement over completely locked system to a system that is open to all developers. Now we just have to use our creativity to invent some cool stuff for this system. As for now, as I know, it was only ported, so the buttons do not work, and if you want to control something, you are not allowed to. It means that it can work if you debug it, if you spend some time with it, it should work.
Short summary, I tried 10 or 11 different distributives of the game and finally found the proper one. I will leave the link in the description if you just want to try it. If you want to see how Doom works on these goggles, you can download from the link. But what I understood, you can use almost every WAD file with Doom inside and it actually should work. Why it didn't work by me from the first attempts, I don't know. Just feel free to try. If you like this video, press like, subscribe, leave the comments below. It's a big event in the history of digital HD transmission systems. The DJI made it very simple, very affordable and working as it should. But now we can push the limits maybe even further. For me, the main complaint about these goggles was the limit of 13 kilometers, that you cannot fly further than 13 kilometers. Maybe now, after the goggles are hacked, we can manage to deal with it and fly even further. That's all for now. Bye.